Because innovation index is concerned, we stand in 45th rank in the world. There are several countries innovatively very good. That means knowledge base is there, skill is there, our mindset is there. Then innovation we can key. Whatever research you do, you should translate into innovation and also translate into products. Excellence will come. Knowledge, excellence, innovation. So these three are the keywords in the entire process. Sustainable development is the important. Development is required, but it should be sustained longer. Economic slowdown, because our GDP growth rate is coming down. We are aiming for 9%, but we are reaching as low as 5.5%. So that means our something going wrong in the country. We need to have an economic slowdown. We should not allow. Dramatic change in demography. Today, there are no boundaries are drawn. Student can go anywhere in the world, pursue education. Our demographics are changing. Cultural boundaries redrawn. So the different cultures should be able to work with. Similarly, major shift in higher education. Shift is taking place. Now we have the different kinds of universities coming. We have central universities, we have state universities, we have deemed universities, we have private universities, we have institutions of national importance, we have IITs, NITs, IITs. Our shift is taking place in higher education because the government alone cannot provide higher education to the needy people. Today, 80% education is given by private sector. So we have to ensure, they also provide, but to ensure quality at the central level, state level, as well as the private level. So intense competition among universities we have to build. So we have central universities there, we have Maulana, Azad, Open University, Urdu University is there, Osmani University is there. Competition, professional competence among universities we have to build. Then only we can able to. Similarly, corporate universities are coming in now. Now we say 600 acres, lovely campus. They say they'll provide all AC rooms, AC dining hall, all that. Corporate, they're also coming. Whereas central state university, we cannot afford. Providing a room itself is difficult for us. So the corporate universities are also coming. Student tendency to go into these corporate universities. So the competition is coming. Virtual university. Many universities in the world, they're going virtual environment. So virtual classrooms, virtual universities, providing education. Student need not come to campus. He can learn from home or workplace. So that is also happening using technology. Okay, 63% workforce in India is illiterate. So as you know, an 18 to 24 age group is only coming to 12 to 15% higher education. 40% population below 18 years are, that is the, below 18 years, we have 40% is there. Large youngster base is there. But European countries, youngsters we don't find. Many of the aging population. That is the India asset is that we have young population. 55 million youngsters in IT, in the age group are there. So we, as I said, 12 to 15% only coming to the higher education. Quickly can run through. So we have, say, Japan, we have 4,000 universities, USA, 3,500 universities, and India, 600 plus. Of course, the 430 was the world slide. 600 plus universities are there now and provide more than 1.45 billion, as youngsters are given education. And gross enrollment ratio, we want to move from 15 to 30%. In fact, our distinguished guest, Professor Ramaswamy, also highlighted. So an increasing gross enrollment ratio. Developed countries 55%, more than that, world average is 23%, as I mentioned. Okay, and I think it takes 1 hour, but I don't have time. What I will say is quickly run through slides, can quickly. To achieve and major greater increase in education inclusion, high quality and better attainment rates. Attaining is important. Yeah, prepare for change, develop expertise, relate the knowledge economy. Education is workhorse of economy. Education is there, economy will grow. Social needs are important. Okay, can. So what is the focus is quality, relevance, employability, citizenship, and societal. These are important factors which one we need to apply in the university system. Focus should be there. What is the focus on education? Yeah, universities should have a networking, benchmarking, knowledge sharing, advocacy, ICT technology, distance and vocational and skill-based updation courses. And formal F2F, face-to-face learning is important. But apart from that, we also require open and online learning, mentoring concept, American universities introduced called concept called mentoring. Every 10 students, there will be a mentor. But we are already shortage of faculty. We are not able to put mentors. We need to have a 1:10. Every 10 students, there should be mentoring. And educational research to be packaged. So all our content of the courses to be packaged should be made available to students so that not only in the classroom, you can also access from the home. Virtual learning, cutting-edge technology are available today in the worldwide. I think that we should need to. For India, of course, formal structured courses, job-oriented courses, diploma, certificate, integrated dual degree, twinning program, exchange program, joint degree, distance education, offline, online, industry-sponsored program. These are some of the areas where university can introduce. The government support right now is only 0.5% education. We need to have 1.5 to 2% of GDP. Then only universities can grow. Right now, Professor Ramasam, in fact, they are getting about 165 crores from the government. They need about 300 crores. They're finding extremely difficult to impart education. So funding is required. And state universities are starving for funds. They get 1/4 or 1/3 of the cost of the what they incurred. So these are some of the problems. Tuition fee, upper limit, government say 20% only. We can't charge more from the universities. So maximum 20% we can get from student. So UGC plan, non-plan grant, consultant services, funding from industry. Industry is not coming a big way in this country. Whereas American universities, large funding comes from industry. India, they don't have confidence in university. So, and the university doesn't go to industry. So we somehow something lacking in India. In Germany, the vice chancellor of the university will go to next day, managing director of industry. Managing director of industry next day come as vice chancellor. It's not happening in, both are shy, sharing each other. So self-financed courses, of course, we have distance education. Some that is a more income for universities nowadays. That's the only way to bridge the gap. Research support, funding agencies, other source of revenue generation we have to think of. Technology-enabled learning. Best practice we have to improvement in the universities and institution. Best practice, technology-enabled learning. Not only simple, because we have to use the technology in the classroom. Digital classrooms are required everywhere. So BITS Pilani experimented digital classroom. In Dubai campus, they impart education from Pilani. Like that, 4 campuses are connected. One lecture a year will be accessible to others everywhere. So the technology is important. Innovative approaches for evaluation assessment. Normally, we recommend 25 to 50% internal assessment. University, they declare calendar beginning of year and stick to the dates. In our system, we have several problems. So we are not able to come a common calendar. Introduction of professional multidisciplinary curricula, developing lateral entry in the higher education, flexible higher education system like arts, science, engineering. But engineering, we are not studying the economics, accountancy, business practices, English literature, heritage, culture. Engineering student doesn't know about this. So like that, arts and social science students, they know, should know technology, how to use the computer. So these are the interdisciplinary approaches we need in the system. Testing system, measurement of skills and application testing, acceptable accreditation system. Every institution should go for accreditation, whatever accreditation system they accept. Attracting international students, high quality research, societal upliftment. And of course, these are some of the ideas which you have given. Next slide, I think. Okay, thank you so much. I think I wish I could have more time, but.
Taru, member UGC. So thank you very much, sir. Now we thank the chief guest of the occasion. With the memento, I request our pro vice chancellor, Professor Khaja Muhammad Shahi Saab, to hand over the memento to.
Honorable Professor Reddy, Honorable Professor Ramaswamy, Dean's Faculty of Management, Head of the Department of Management, my colleagues, students, ladies and gentlemen. You must be observing, we all are short of time rushing through the various speeches and presentations, which gives us a feeling of not getting whatever complete information we should get. Rushing through the presentation. It was very good, very exhaustive, very complete presentation from Dr. Reddy. And I think set the ball rolling for the next 2 days, what we should discuss and where our seminar should put the focus. Thank you very much, sir, for such a nice presentation and a very brief presidential intervention by Professor Ramaswamy, where he has emphasized upon the need of education for all and Indianization of education and, of course, education and language and education in your mother tongue. Some of these issues which are dear to all of us, and these two distinguished speakers of this morning have raised these issues. I am thankful to them, and their very, very brief interventions and presentations, they have raised very, very important issues of higher education. Ladies and gentlemen, when I thought of this seminar, and I discussed with the Vice Chancellor that management of higher education, why we chose the Department of Management, why we did not go to Faculty of Education or some other faculty. Because in my opinion, my mind, sir, ladies and gentlemen, the issue is now more and more becoming more important, managing all those things which they have talked about, the concern which they have shown, the technology which they have talked about, the need which they have talked about. I am feeling, and we are all feeling more and more, that the issue of managing all these things are also becoming very, very important. Our skills are not matching the managerial requirements of higher education institutions or higher education missions or higher education plans and programs. I do not want to take very long time and do not want to detain my distinguished guests because they have further engagements. But the point which I want to put before these two distinguished, the Vice Chancellor, the former Vice Chancellor, and other faculty members and young students, that today the management of higher education is becoming more and more a complex issue. You just heard from Dr. Reddy that how many new things have come in technology, competition, diversification, expansion, globalization, so many things have come in. And more new skills and developing skills are required to manage this institution. Therefore, I think the Department of Management and managerial skills and the modern management skills are required to manage these universities. Management of universities or higher education is a very dynamic process. It's a very dynamic process. It's not a very static process. The system is so fast changing. The demands of the system are so fast changing. The pressure on the system is so huge. Therefore, the management is also to be very responsive, very dynamic. And that requires all those things which we have just been talked about by Dr. Reddy and Dr. Professor Ramaswamy, that we have to have skills, we have to have knowledge, we have to have behavioral changes also. The very important point which Dr. Reddy has mentioned, we have to have a behavioral improvements in our behavior, dealing with students, dealing with faculty, dealing with the society, dealing with other stakeholders, the government, the University Grants Commission, whosoever are our stakeholders. So we do not have to depend or cannot depend on old tools, old skills or behavioral aspects or knowledge or skills. What I'm trying to emphasize before this distinguished gathering this morning, that the management of all those things which he has talked about is also a very specialized area now. It requires a very specialized intervention, requires a very specialized attention of those who are at the helm of the affairs in policy planning or management of higher education. Now, one aspect which I would like to draw quickly your attention to is recruitment. Or the need of faculty, or need of the other staff, technical staff, or support. Now, how good are we in our these processes? How fast are we in our these processes? How good are we getting in the best people for the best job in the area of higher education? Compared to the other corporate world, how they are recruiting their manpower resources, and how we are recruiting our manpower resources. This is just one example. Financial resources also, Dr. Reddy has talked about how they are mobilizing financial resources, how we are mobilizing our financial resources, how we are dependent upon one source or of UGC or a state government or whatever is our funding agency. So we have to look forward to different ways of managing our different aspects of higher education. That's what we wanted that this seminar should devote its attention to. And that's why I have given this seminar to Department of Management and not to the Faculty of Education or something else like that. That was my idea, that more and more modern management tools should be applied to management practice or corporate practices should be applied in the management of higher education. That's what perhaps we are looking forward. I do not mean that the answer is only in just 1 + 2 + 2 + 5, like very mechanical answer. It's a complex system. Higher education is a very wide system in India, it's a very diversified system and huge system. So it requires similar responses, similar complex responses and diversified responses from the managers of the system. Managers like vice chancellors, UGC, or faculty members or other staff members, they have to gear up, they have to upgrade their skills, upgrade their other resources to manage these challenges in such a manner that we can stand up before the world, before the globalized education system which is just talked about, and we are among the best in the world. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I thank my distinguished president of the morning, Professor Ramaswamy. I requested him. He has a very busy schedule. Kindly, sir, you have agreed. And Dr. Reddy, very nice of you, sir, to spare your valuable time and giving such a valuable input to us. Thank you very much, sir.
And to Professor Khwaja Muhammad Shahi Sahib as a mark of thanks to him.
No, sir, bye.
Professor D.N. Reddy R.O. and Professor Ramaswamy, sir. Now I request my colleague Dr. Badiuddin Saab to give a vote of thanks. Dr. Badiuddin Saab.
A very good morning to all of you and respected guest. I am thankful to you for being present here on this occasion and gracing the occasion. Thank you very much, sir, Professor DMDD and Professor Ramaswamy. Sir, Professor Khajam Shahid, and the Registrar Sahab, Rahmatullah Sahab, and other professors, deans, heads of the department, and colleagues of teaching and non-teaching who have been here. Today's function. Also thankful to the our students, scholars who have been day out and day night being rendering services to making the seminar great success. My sincere gratitude goes to all of my staff, teaching and non-teaching at the seminar, who has tirelessly worked for the success of the seminar. It was not one man's show, but the collective efforts of all of us. I express my heartiest thanks to the press and media who have been with us to cover this event. My heartfelt gratitude goes to all our well-wishers and all who have come here for different parts to join us in this event. Thank you, one and all. And we'll have a tea break around 11:30. After that, we'll start our first technical session. Please rejoin us at 12 p.m. sharp. Can you reassemble here for the first technical session?
I welcome all the participants, dignitaries, to this valedictory session of today national seminar on management of higher education, prospectives, challenges, and strategies. Not taking much time on this occasion, the session will start with the recitation of Quran Pak. I request Mushahid Raza, MBA, fourth semester student, to come and recite Quran.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تشتهي ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم صدق الله المولانا العظيم.
I am going to translate at first into Urdu language, after then into English language. Please listen carefully and effectiveness with these phrases. بے شک وہ جنہوں نے کہا ہمارا رب اللہ ہے پھر اس پر قائم رہے ان پر فرشتے اترتے ہیں کہ نہ ڈرو اور نہ غم کرو اور خوش ہو اس جنت پر جس کا تمہیں وعدہ دیا جاتا تھا ہم تمہارے دوست ہیں دنیا کی زندگی میں اور آخرت میں اور تمہارے لیے اس میں وہ ہے جو تمہارا جی چاہے اور تمہارے لیے اس میں وہ ہے جو تم مانگو مہمانی بخشنے والے مہربان کی طرف سے. In into English language, indeed those who said Allah is our Lord and remain from upon it, upon them descend the angels saying, don't fear nor grieve and be happy for the paradise which you are promised. We are your friends into life of this world and in the hereafter. In it for you is all that you may wish for, and in it for you is all what you ask. The hospitality from the forgiving, most merciful. Thank you so much.
Hafiz Mushahid Raza, MBA 4th semester student. Now, I request Organizing Secretary Dr. Sanim Fatima, Associate Professor, Department of Business Management, and Head of the Department, to present the report and also formally welcome the guest.
Dr. Azim, Chief Guest for today's validatory session, Madam Professor Sunaina Singh, Honorable Vice Chancellor, English and Foreign Languages University, Hyderabad, Keynote Speaker, Professor Faizan Mustafa, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Nalsar University of Law, Hyderabad, Dr. Khwaja M. Shahid, Honorable Pro Vice Chancellor, Maulana Azad National Urdu University, Director of Distance Education and in charge Dean, School of Commerce and Business Management, Professor K.R. Iqbal Ahmed, members of teaching and non-teaching fraternity, participants, students, and all of you present here, a very good afternoon to all of you and a warm welcome to the validatory session of the two-day national seminar on Management of Higher Education, Perspectives, Challenges, and Strategies. Before we start the validatory report, I would like to welcome formally and request Dr. Khwaja M. Shahid to welcome Professor Sunaina Singh, Chief Guest, with the bouquet. Thank you, sir. I request Dean Professor K.R. Iqbal Ahmed Sahab to welcome Professor Faizan Mustafa, keynote speaker. I request the Dean to also welcome our Honorable Pro Vice Chancellor, Dr. Khwaja M. Shahid.
Now, I request our Organizing Secretary to formally welcome the Dean, School of Commerce and Business Management, Sanim Fatima, you can.
I'm honored to be standing here to deliver this valedictory report because of having had the privilege of being among such distinguished administrators and academic guests. Valedictory functions like these are an occasion to reflect upon the proceedings we have had over the last 2 days, more so on the accomplishments and ways to improve in future such occasions, and to thank all those responsible for the successful conduct of this seminar. The seminar was inaugurated yesterday by the Chief Guest, Professor D. Narasimha Reddy, Chairman RAC, DRDO, Ministry of Defense, member UGC, former Vice Chancellor of JNTU, Hyderabad. The inaugural session was presided by Professor R. Ramaswamy, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Hyderabad Central University. The distinguished guests were introduced by the Dean, Department of Management and Commerce, Professor K.R. Iqbal Ahmed. The chief guest in his inaugural address focused upon skill development, and he discussed about the challenges we had and compared the examples of Korea and other developing countries which have imbibed the various, and he also proposed that we could have collaborated with these foreign universities who are doing excellent in skill development, other programs. He focused that education is not the luxury or way of economic development, but it is a necessity. The inaugural session was ended by the closing address of inaugural by Honorable Pro Vice Chancellor Dr. Khwaja M. Shahid, followed by vote of thanks by Dr. Badiuddin Ahmed. In the inaugural session, after the inaugural session, to repeat once again, we have received more than 100 papers on the various themes of the seminar, 10 sub-themes of the seminar. Only 50 papers were shortlisted after double-blind peer review, and they were divided. The papers' 50 contributions were divided into 6 technical sessions. Each technical session was chaired by a resource chairperson from eminent academician and industry exposure. The 6 technical sessions are: session 1 was assessment and accreditation of higher education, issues of policy planning, management, and governance of higher education. This session was chaired by Professor Najma Akhtar, and the convener for this session was Dr. Badiuddin Ahmed. During this session, we have had very good contributions from paper presenters on governance of higher education, to name a few, and renovating higher education for sustainable development, how technology can play a major role in economic development through higher education. Session 2 was on RUSA and overview, and infrastructure and financial management in higher education. We have got very good assessment and feedback about the RUSA. Session 2, the chairperson was Professor Hasibullah, consultant and academician, and the convener was Dr. Dastagir Alam. Technical session 3 was on foreign direct investment and public-private partnership in higher education, and also human resource management in higher education. This session was chaired by Dr. N.A. Khan, School of Economics from Hyderabad Central University, and the convener for this session was Dr. M.A. Azim. Here, once again, we have had very good sessions on managing human resources in higher education, role of bringing education in social change, and human resource management in higher education, the challenges, and some of the very good suggestions were contributed here. That was these were the proceedings of day 1. Day 2 started with the technical session 4 on impact of higher education in economic development. The chairperson for this session was Dr. Shabaz Ahmed, Director Amjad Ali Khan of College of Business Administration and Industry Practitioner. The convener for this session was Dr. N.I. Mullah. We have had titles here as impact of higher education in economic development. The sessions in this technical sessions had very good debate and deliberations from the participants and the students of management. Technical session 5 was based on contribution of ICT in management of higher education, chaired by Professor A. Sudhakar, Registrar, B.R. Ambedkar Open University, and the convener for this session was Dr. Syed Khaja Safiuddin. And as said, we have received maximum number of papers among all the sub-themes as ICT in higher education and role of distance education in higher education. It was rather difficult to scrutinize these papers and shortlist them, but we had very good papers on this theme too, integration of ICT into higher education, opportunities and challenges, and many more such papers. The last technical session was on role of distance education in higher education, chaired by Dr. S.M. Ilyas, ex-Vice Chancellor, Faizabad University, Uttar Pradesh, and currently sir is Director of Distance Education, National Institute of Rural Development, Hyderabad. The convener for this session was Dr. S.K. Kamruddin, the last session. Here we have discussed about some of the very good papers where they have focused on how distance education and role of distance education in higher education, how we can contribute to personality development and overall its role in economic development. So these were the technical sessions chaired by various resource persons and conveners. So to sum up, going by the theme of the seminar, we had presentations and papers by almost 52 participants from across the country, which were very insightful, which led to intellectual discussions among the panel members, major concerns with respect to the perspectives, challenges, and strategies on management of higher education in India were debated and discussed. We intend to bring out an ISBN numbered book on the proceedings of this seminar, which will include the views and opinions of chairpersons and the guests who have graced the seminar and shared their valuable experiences and suggestions. At this moment, I also request our honored guest for this valedictory session, the chief guest, Madam Sunaina Singh, and keynote speaker, Professor Faidan Mustafa, also to send a soft copy of your speech or lecture so that we can incorporate in the ISBN book. Okay, it's being recorded. Okay. So this is about the report of the two-day seminar. At the outset, I thank our Honorable Vice-Chancellor, Professor Mohammed Mia Sahab, for encouraging and supporting us to conduct this seminar. We wish and hope the university will prosper and is prospering under his capacity and guidance. The seminar would not have been what it is without the able guidance of Dr. Khaja M. Shahid, our Honorable Pro-Vice-Chancellor, who translated the encouragement of our Vice-Chancellor into motivation with his timeless support and guidance. Thank you, sir. The department, including students, research scholars, under the leadership of Dean Professor K.R. Iqbal Ahmed Sahab, worked day and night for the last few weeks to put in place all the various aspects of coordination and make this seminar a smooth affair. Thank you, sir, for being with us and making this possible. I thank the Registrar, Professor Rahmatullah, Maulana Azad National University, for his ever-ready help. Coming to the department, I'm thankful to all my colleagues, Professor Dastagir Alam Sahab, Dr. Badiyuddin Ahmed, Dr. Muhammad Abdul Azim Sahab, Dr. Kamruddin, Dr. Sayyid Khaja Safiuddin, Mr. Saeed Alavi, Ms. Kavita Meena, all my research scholars and students, and the support staff, Ms. Asra Rana, Pasha Bhai, and all others who worked incessantly in all my endeavors to make this seminar a successful one. I thank also Dr. Anaimullah and Sada Sharif for their contribution in the conduct of this seminar. I thank the director of CPDMT, Professor Mazharuddin Farooqi, and Dr. Muhammad Shujat Ali for their facilitation in the arranging the auditorium and other facilities for the conduct of the seminar. I also have to thank Dr. Muhammad Faryat for his support to the press and media. I thank Professor Wahab Khaisar Sahab, Dean of Instructional Media Centre, and the staff for coverage of this event. Finally, I have to thank all the participants, especially those who have come from far-off states like Gujarat, Kashmir, various states of India, for making this seminar such a participative, and as Madam Najma Akhtar has commented yesterday, the group of this seminar, the contributions, as such, when the first term, if you see management of higher education, at the outset it looks that it is the domain of the management teachers to contribute here, but we have had contributions from technical people, NIT, Kharagpur, and various institutes. So the group was very heterogeneous, and the views were heterogeneous, and we have had very good deliberations and debates for the 2 days. Thank you, all the participants. And there are a lot many people who have contributed in the successful conduct of this seminar. I thank them all, whose name I have missed to mention. Thank you, one and all.
Yeah, this was Dr. Saneem Fatima, Organizing Secretary.
No need for vote of thanks. She has already done vote of thanks.
Organizing Secretary of this seminar. It would be a privilege for the Department of Management and Commerce to bring up a second edited book, if we could bring this book. Last year we had a seminar on FDI in service sector opportunities and challenges in the month of May, and we bought a book with 72 very good papers. That was the first book in the department, and this would be the second book. So hope this book will be released shortly. And going to the next, I request Professor K.R. Iqbal Ahmed Sahab, in charge, Dean, School of Commerce and Business Management, and Director of Distance Education, to introduce the guests.